standard of the Bible for Australia, it would have been easy. But the whole standard is the whole standard. Jesus the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. I can't self-pedal it. I can't bring it down. Strength to overcome is focus. Have you tried it? No, I'm committed to this youth ministry. No, I'm committed to this. No matter what the public is doing, no matter whatever anybody is doing, my priority is my commitment to this youth ministry. Strength to overcome. And immediately you take the first step, God will empower you. See, that's my story. The drama I sent to you, the devil said to the first girl, deny Jesus and you'll be free. The devil is a liar. After he denied Jesus, the girl was still shouting. The second person, deny Jesus and you'll be free. The second person denied. I said, look at the third person. Watch it, because that drama was articulated by mature writers of the Bible. I mean, mature Christians. The lady said, no. When I lost my dad, when I lost my mom, Jesus was there. The third person. Look at the tribulation. Here. Before Jesus. Jesus was watching. Look at the tribulation. The lady resisted unto them. When you go home, watch it again. Before Jesus, Jesus did not do anything. The devil was acting. The devil would do all somersault, use Bruce Lee, Jet Li. But one thing in the presence of Jesus, because that old lady is bearing the name of Jesus, she cannot die. She had tribulation with persecution. Tribulation. But after the last one, what happened? Jesus stood up. When Jesus stood up, everything against the girl. Remember? Until Jesus stood up. When Jesus stood up, everything about the girl, everything that was against the girl, what happened? The people that wrote that drama, that's the kind of, let me tell you, not to boast, just humble yourself and prepare, because I can't beg you. I can't beg you. If you have time, you want to really portray messages through drama. You show me that you are ready. Because I wouldn't want any of my child to start anything without finishing it. See the message. When Jesus stood up, the devil knelt down. It was very clear. The people that articulated that, it was accurate. The message was awesome for those that really want to learn. And immediately, all those people that were kicking her, doing this, doing that, doing kicking, they knelt down, they get stood up. Freedom at last. Strength to overcome. Strength, let me tell you. I don't know. It's making you as if heaven is not real and hell is real. They are very real. They are very, very, very real. It's as another thing that is occurring to you is as if God is not real. God, what God says in this world is a lie. You are deceiving yourself. You are deceiving yourself. If you are saying there is a mistake in this Bible, that is not true. The wise are using it to overcome. Look at me, look at you. Look at your position in Australia. Look at your status in Australia. Look at my status. I'm succeeding with wisdom, not money. Don't need money. I'm moving forward. Nobody can stop me. No. The Bible said if the devil has understood, he would have killed. He said we speak mystery, wisdom that is above the devil. Look at you young men, 20 years, between 20 and 30 years. I discovered my real self around 32 years. 30. How wish you know who you are? Can you read that verse again? This as a question to yourself. You ask yourself, Marie Gede Mushu.
I read again. In your struggle against sin, have you not yet resisted to the point of shedding your blood?
That woman before.
In your struggle against unbelief, have you not yet resisted to the point of shedding your blood?
Have you not yet resisted? Is that?
Yeah.
I want to, okay, let me leave that now. Let me get it. I want to read with the four versions. Do you know Christianity? Okay. Ye have not yet resisted unto blood, striving against sin. You are ready, you are seeing your blood going to flow. Last Sunday I was here. I had no strength, no single strength. I was here. If I tell you all that I overcame with just being taking that bold step to be here, I destroy sickness. I destroy money wastage. I destroy, because immediately God saw my heart. I didn't go announcing it to anybody, shouting to everybody. It's my way. I'm saying, if I perish, I perish. As a pastor, what will I be doing now? Can you open Luke 21, verse 19? We'll close with that. But I want to show something in Luke. Did I say Luke?
Yes.
Luke 21. Okay, let's read the. Let's read the first Luke 9. It should be Luke 9. 16. Let's start from 59.
I read.
No, start from 57. Be fast. Yes. I think we've taken our time.
57. As they were walking along the road, the man said to them, I will follow you wherever you go.
Lord, I will follow you. Let's say in Australia. I'll follow you wherever you go, Lord. Continue.
58. Jesus replied. Foxes have dens.
Foxes have where they sleep.
And birds have nests.
Birds have where they sleep.
But the Son of Man has no place to lay his head.
But I have no place to lay my head.
59.
And now 59. Jesus now asks another person.
He said to another man,
Follow
me.
Follow me.
But he replied. Lord, first let me go and bury my father.
Okay.
60. Jesus said to him, let the dead bury their own dead. But you go and proclaim the kingdom of God.
And preach. This is supposed to be somebody that already has vision. Yes?
61.
Yes.
Stay. Another said, I will follow you, Lord. But first let me go back and say goodbye to my family. Jesus replied, no one who puts a hand to the pillow
to the plough
and looks back is fit for service in the kingdom of God.
Did you see it here, church? Now, Jesus is saying, if you are like somebody that is on the race, and they said, on your marks, get saved. See, if you look back, you're not fit for the kingdom. Now, we have diluted it. We have made people to think you can carry Christianity on the left and carry your vision on the right. That is nonsensical piece of radical nonsense. The English that my family has been learning for years. Nonsensical piece of radical nonsense. This is a piece of, let me explain that in English. This is a nonsense piece. Nonsensical piece. And it's also radical, a radical nonsense. I tell you, it's a piece of nonsense. Nonsensical piece of medical nonsense. So, Samuel, are you getting it? You wonder why Pastor Joseph, all the way from Nigeria, no help, man has betrayed me, man has done all sorts of things, yet I'm moving as if nothing has ever happened. I'm building my family at the same time, building the church, building my educational skill, learning at the same time to build school in Nigeria, building everything at the same time. Why? Because anytime he comes and says, Idika, you're going to have blood pressure. You are overworking yourself. You are going to die and you're going to have sickness. I'll say, if I perish, I'll perish. I'm going to school. I'm working. I'm pastoring. I'm looking after doing my normal as an Igbo man. I'm husband. Everything. At the same time, strength to overcome. You need it if you must succeed in Australia. You need to overlook so many things. You have to understand that the law cannot be changed because you are in Australia. And I keep on saying it as I challenge every of my children, it will be a taboo for me. It will be a sin. If any of you come to heaven and be greater than me, can't be greater than me. It's not, you can't be greater than me. I challenge you. If I'm the one that is getting all this revelation and doing everything, you can't be greater than me. Praise the Lord. The son of angels hovering over his house. Church, remember he says, finally, everybody open to the book of Luke, chapter 21, verse 19. Yes.
Luke 21, verse 19.
Yes.
Stand firm, and you will win life.
That's a beautiful version. What did he say?
Stand firm, and you will win life.
In as much as it's beautiful, it's not as strong as the message the Bible is portraying here. He says, stand firm and you will live. Now look at King James. In your patience, possess your soul. So the first key to gathering the strength to overcome every facet, every challenge in every facet of your life is what? Focus, deciding. If I perish, I perish. What's the number two? Number two is patience. You might take a step. Doctor, I'm going to church with my wayward knees. They say it's cancer. I'm going to church. No. I'm not going to see Pastor Joseph. I'm not going to see any pastor. I'm just going there because I've agreed with the Lord. I'm a member of the women. I'm a member of the men. Let me perish there with your wayward knees. If it's ambulance that will make you, we want to go to church. Pian, you sit in the church. Oh, Lord, I've done it. I've done it. At least I've done it. After church, you go home. Even if nothing happened, in your patience, possess your soul. In your patience, possess. God cannot lie. And Bishop Mercy Dawson, he was preaching in Benny Hills Church. And he said the foolish ones will wait until I finish preaching before they get their healing. But the wise ones will get their healing as I'm distributing the word of God. Some came only so that Benny Hill will lay hand on them. So the foolish ones will wait until Benny Hill lay their hand on him. But the wise ones will know that as he was teaching, the power of God was present to him. You grab your healing. Mama, he says, heaven can never give you. Don't ever fool yourself thinking that heaven will give you what belongs to you if you do not demand it. Look at it, he said, by going through all these things, you will keep your life. By your endurance, you will protect your life. By your endurance, you will gain your life. Yes, you will really live if you never stop obeying me. By endurance, you will win your life. By your endurance, you will win your life. Let me tell you something you don't know about life, about spirituality, spiritual things. If you've taken the first step, if I die, I die. We are talking about strength to overcome. And when you come, you didn't see anything the first day. You didn't see anything like Naaman the second time, the fourth time, the fifth time. The man of God said seven times. And you keep on moving. You are losing your strength. You are losing your strength. Now, another thing will happen. People will start talking about you. That's another advantage. People will start talking. Look at how foolish. What kind of church is that? What kind of God is that? What kind of religion is that? He's dying and he's going to church every day. He's dying, yet his God cannot heal him. He's dying. And God will say, arise, O Lord. God will arise. I'm telling you, another thing that activates your success, your strength to overcome, is the evil ways of men. When they start talking, God will defend himself. Remember, they are saying, what kind of God is going to, what kind of God is going, immediately they start talking, God says, I've got no reason now. I can't wait for the other reason. They have given me reason. Now let me do it. You know what people have said when they start talking about me? I keep quiet so that they talk more. Because they don't know as they are talking, they are activating God on my behalf. They are activating God on my behalf. What kind of God? What kind of stupid God? What kind of this? Imagine when people start saying that God is hearing everything. God knows everything. What kind of stupid God is he? What kind of, he cannot, he came to Australia. Instead of going into the nitty-gritties of Australia, learning Australia, he's still carrying the Bible. He's still doing this. Instead of throwing away Church of God Mission connection or whatever, or contact with Church of God Mission and start his own, instead of breaking away. Instead of leaving his family, a married Australian lady first and get his citizenship. Then he will now divorce and go and marry his wife. God is hearing. And I'm saying in my spirit, Lord, I'm here to be an example. Lord, I'm here to prove to them that you are the same. Yesterday, today, and forevermore. Lord, I'm here to prove to them that you don't need to lie. You don't need to play gimmicks to succeed. Lord, I'm here on your behalf. And I will never fail. I will possess my soul with endurance, with patience. If I perish, I perish. Lord, I'm here to prove to them. You don't need to lie. You don't need to come on the television and lie that they will kill you if they don't give you citizenship. You don't need to go and lie to a woman or a man and deceive him and deceive her to get your citizenship. Lord, if you cannot do it, then my children are here. They are seeing me. They see my faithfulness. Then they will not believe me. I don't need to lie. I don't need to compromise. Lord, because you are real. And people are talking. Look at that foolish man. When I was going to bury my dad, the Nigerian people came and gave me offering of $560. I said, this is your support. A trip that we spent $26,000. And Nigerian in Australia, they only gave me, it was Igbo, the Igbo, people from my tribe, they gave me the offering of $560. A trip I spent $26,000. And if you ask them, is that not your brother? Why is it that you're not going to their church? Oh, when he wanted to bury his father, we gave him money to go and bury his father. He came back, he started preaching against us. I'm not preaching against you, I'm preaching the truth. You can't lie to a woman that you want to marry the woman, and when you get your citizenship, you divorce the woman and destroy her life. You can't lie to a man that you're going to stay with him for life. When you get your citizenship, you lie and destroy the man. And you want me to give back because you gave me $500. not preaching the truth? You are lying everywhere. Deceiving people, destroying their future. And I'm representing God in Australia, and you want me to keep my mouth shut? God, if you cannot do it, if I perish, I perish. Am I making sense, church? Only one of us to take a decision. Are we ready to walk with God in the standard of the Bible? Or are we ready to do it our own? In the standard of the Bible. Go and ask them in Malaysia. I had members. I share this. Let me conclude with this. I had a guy. Everybody was, anytime he come, he was distributing money, doing whatever. He was among the leaders when we started. 1 year. I said, if you get to 2 years, you will not sing in this choir again with your lifestyle. He thought I was joking. He came to church one day and said, you can't touch that microphone. Do you know what he does? He sleeps with a lady and comes to church. After he will still come with a lady. I said, now you are still 1 year, a baby. You are drinking milk, I will allow it. But now, you are getting into 2 years. I said, Don, I'm going to stop you. One day he came to church after having Ibulala, the girl, enjoying the girl, the girl. They were rushing to take the microphone. I said, it's not in this church any longer. If I perish, I perish. The truth must be established. I said, you can't touch that microphone. Don't touch that microphone. It might not give you that microphone.